Thomas's Church on Fifth Avenue, in the very heart of Manhattan. We're here to attend the world premiere of a new composition, a work for chorus, soloists, and orchestra, a setting of the Requiem Mass. It's been written by an Englishman who's no stranger to this city. On the contrary, a few blocks away on Broadway, his name's been up in lights for many years, connected with shows like Jesus Christ Superstar, Cats, and Evita. Andrew Lloyd Webber is his name, and this is the first time that a work of his has been premiered here in New York City.
We're not meant to, because after we've done our pieces, we come up, because St. Thomas is...
What about the
it's a bit long to remember.
Sarah Brightman will be singing the soprano role. Have you written the part specially for her?
Not in the sense that she can do an awful lot of sort of, I suppose, coloratura tricks and things higher, and I didn't want to write in a whole lot of mock Rossini, but it would obviously be silly if I have her, you know, as it were, on hand, not to try certain things out with her.
There are plenty of cases of composers and conductors working together, but I imagine you must have been very grateful to have had the special experience of Lorin Maazel.
For me, to have the opportunity of discussing orchestrations and tone colours with somebody who has that depth of knowledge of orchestration was one of the most keen that I should leave one synthesizer there. I mean, whether as a token to my other world, but in fact, what the one synthesizer, which is the one electric instrument we have, does do is it does give one a range of colors that I don't think we could otherwise get.
Why New York?
Well, it's one of those accidents of timing. It so happened that Placido was in New York, and we felt that everybody was able to be there at the one time. I mean, it's like, as you know, getting all these people together for one performance. I mean, all serious classical artists seem to work at least 10 years ahead, and there was this one day where everybody appeared to be in New York.
It is a beautiful sound of St. Thomas's, but what a culture shock to be in New York and to step in from Tiffany's across the road, and then you're suddenly in St. Thomas's hearing music, which could be in an English cathedral close.
Not as strange a culture shock as hearing the Requiem Mass